I'm Kaylee, and today I want to tell you about how I built some custom bookshelves. So I had this idea that I wanted to build some bookshelves specifically to display children's picture books for my little nieces when they come over to visit. And I had the available wall space in the hallway, so I thought, you know what? We're gonna do this. We're gonna buy some lumber when lumber costs an arm and a leg in America. And we're gonna build some custom bookshelves. Let's do it. If you haven't already, please do subscribe to this channel and give this video a big thumbs up if you love amazing bookshelves. I will leave a link down in the description for the tutorial that I used in order to create these amazing bookshelves. So the first thing I did was I went out and bought some 1x2x8 foot boards, and I got some 1x4x8 foot boards. And I had to sand those down and put on wood glue and nails and nail all of that together into the correct shape. So I actually had a diagram of how all of those were gonna fit together and where the nails go and all of that good stuff. So I just followed those instructions and put everything together based on where the nails were supposed to fit. Then I filled in the nail holes with wood filler and sanded over those and painted everything. I put on 1 coat of primer and 2 coats of paint, and then we were ready to install the shelves onto the wall. So using a level and painter's tape, I marked where the shelves were gonna go on the wall, and I had to find the studs and mark where the studs would be so that I wouldn't have to use wall anchors, but so that we could drill the shelves right into the studs behind the wall. That was where I had to call in for some help, and I got my dad and my brother to come over and help me to install these and drill all the holes and everything. And we fastened each shelf into the wall with screws and drilled it into place. We used 2.5 inch drywall screws so that it is very sturdy. And then all I had to do was go in and touch up with a little bit of paint and cover over the screws with a little bit more wood filler and touch up a little bit of paint there. When we took off the painter's tape after the shelves were up, we wadded up the painter's tape into these big rosettes, which then we wore proudly on our lapels. So just having fun with it and just being silly and having a good time installing those shelves together with my family. And then I got to decorating. My nieces loved it so much. They think it's amazing that they have their own special bookshelf. The books on the bottom are for the any child to grab at any time. Those are all board books, or books that I don't mind if they get ripped or chewed on. But the books at the top are the beautiful books that no one is allowed to touch because they're too gorgeous to live. Those can only be read with adult supervision so that the beautifulness does not get messed up. I had such an amazing time putting together these really cool bookshelves. It was quite a project. It took me several weeks of doing a little bit here, a little bit there, wherever I would find time throughout the day. But I am so, so pleased with the result. And you know, the video footage and the pictures don't even do it justice. It is just so beautiful. Every time I walk down the hallway, I am just so delighted with this beautiful wall of books. When my roommate saw this, she said, "Wow, we really do live in a library." And at that moment I knew that all of my dreams have come true. I live in a library. There are books in every room, in every surface is just covered in books. Even though I have absolutely no experience with woodworking or any kind of building anything, I was able to follow this tutorial and I was able to do it. It's not perfect. Certainly there are little spots that are messed up or places where the nails are not quite straight, but a little bit of paint pretty much covers up those things. And anyway, everybody's looking at the books. People aren't really looking at the errors and the messed up places on the woodwork. So it is by no means a professional job. It is very much like the worst of an amateur's job, but I don't really care. I mean, it looks homemade and it is homemade, and that is okay. And it really wasn't as hard as I thought it would be to do. I got some help and some advice from my dad and my brother, and it turned out great. Please leave me a comment down below and let me know, would you ever consider installing some custom bookshelves like these? Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and remember, the right book in the right hands at the right time can change the world.